Early this month, the Electoral Commission body handed over its former offices to the Ugandan National Roads Authority to pave way for the construction of the Kampala flyover. Today, the Commission has officially opened its new offices, which are located on 7th Street Industrial Area in the building which once housed Ugandan National Housing. The function was graced by the Minister of Justice and Constitutional Affairs, Norbert Mao. Mao noted that, much as the commission is about organizing elections for the country, it must have good laws. He reiterated the call to them to consider electoral reforms, adding that the constitutional reforms are also long overdue.
You have some ideas on how to strengthen and improve the laws. We eagerly await for those improvements, including proposals for constitutional reform, which is on my desk.
He, however, cautioned Ugandans that as much as they disagree or reject some laws or decisions, they must remain respectful. On a lighter note, the minister lashed out at some sections of Ugandans who have continued to feed the president on lies.
Because the president is the target of these snake oil peddlers. These are Chiwani people. The president, in his good faith, listens to everybody. So they go and tell him, General Wamala is evicting the Electoral Commission. What shall we do? We have so many activities. I think the president needs stronger bodyguards.
The Minister of Works and Transport, General Edward Katumba Wamala, hailed the Electoral Commission for its flexibility to shift from their former offices, giving them assurance that they are working hard to see that they finally get a permanent home which will be located along Entebbe Road.
The press is very, very strategic for developing a facility like the Electoral Commission's facility. And so they will get away from this business of hiring Chambogo, Sujui Nambole, Sujui where. Everything will be fitted in that place.
The Electoral Commission Chairperson, Justice Simon Biabakama, observed that although the new offices are temporary, they are comfortable and can easily be accessed by the public.
And you know where we have come from. We had dubbed the place a swamp, a mizigo, and so on and so forth. But here we are. And whenever honorable ministers who used to get guests from other electoral bodies would start perspiring and sweating. You know, it's like when people come to your home when it's disabled and disorganized, you get very uncomfortable, although you are the host.
He called on the government to speed up the efforts to see that they get a permanent home, thus making a commitment to the public of always ensuring free and fair elections. Report compiled by Jaliet Namuwaya for the news.